said you might, but the worst part of this old man is actually old. Brethren, that is not even the concern of Jesus. That is not the concern of our Lord Jesus. Whether you have been long waiting for your husband to come, you are 40 years, you are 45 years, you are 50 years, and the husband have not come, and you are getting discouraged and saying that is the end, the menopause are setting, a lot of things are setting, and the devil began to suggest some things to you and say, no, you look at it now. You see, the husband of this woman was actually old. He quotes, tell me, a man can no longer produce a child. That is not the interest of God. What you have to do is to bring him in. Bring him in. If you are in America, what you need to do? Bring Jesus in. If you are in Asia, what you need to do? As you are listening to me, bring Jesus in. If you are in Africa, what you need to do? Bring Jesus in. Stop visiting those families. Stop indulging yourself with all those occultic members, thinking that that is where you get solution. No. The only one that can give you solution is the Lord Jesus. That is the one that can give you joy. That is the one that can give you peace. That is the one that can give you heavy love. Bring him in, and he will smile again. Bring him in. And the woman could not believe it. And the Bible says something. You see, don't, man of God, don't tell me lies. In that verse 16, look at it. You see, don't tell me lies. Let's look at it again. Just be with me and look at it. You see, don't lie to me. That's when the miracle wants to come. When miracle of the Lord wants to come into your life, you'll be recounting as a lie. You see, is it really true? You see, she said, no, my master, O prophet, do not lie to your servant. Look at in verse 17, look at it in verse 17. What happened in the verse 16, that big part of verse 16 is the human flesh. Is the flesh of the person talking. That is the human flesh reporting and saying the miracle that is about to come is a lie. Don't accept that word. Reject it. Look at that verse. That big part of verse 16. He said, no. How will you say no to the miracle of God? Why would she say no? She couldn't believe it. But she has brought in the man of God into her house. She has brought him called into her. That's an automatic thing for a miracle to come into your life. Look at it here. He said, no, my master, prophet, do not lie to your servant. The man of God did not say anything. Verse 17 said, the woman did conceive at a specified time. Oh my God. At a specified time. At a specified time, the next year, she gave birth to a son, just as Elisha had told her. I want to say something to your life. If you are watching me, you are watching me right away, as you are hearing my voice right away, as a servant of the Most High, as a prophet of the Most High, I speak this to your life. By this time next year, you will carry the gift in your arm. You will carry the promise of God in your hand. You will carry the check in your hand. If you have no child, by this time next year, your baby will be in your arm. You'll be moving forward to the church for dedication. By this time next year, your business might have gone up. It will no longer go down. Before this time next year, your wedding ring will be in your hand. Before this time next year, you have to better wear your wedding gown and be in your husband's house and you'll be celebrating. I see you surrounding this dining table with your children, smiling and jubilating. I see you having a great joy. Before this time next year, tears of joy will come through your eyes. Before this time next year, you will jump and shout, hallelujah. Before this time next year, something great will happen in your home. Before this time next year, you that have been paralyzed, you will stand up and begin to walk. The stick in your hand will be thrown away. The wheelchair before you will go off. before this time.